Hey yo, thanks for tuning in to Celeb Source, your source for celeb news. Now today we got Dr. Dre's wife ramping up the accusation charge and Kodak Black denied. The streaming numbers are in and let's see what the streets have to say about that. Yo, thanks for tuning in to Celeb Source. If this is your first time to the channel, be sure to subscribe, make sure you hit that notification bell icon. Hey yo, Donnie X, I feel you bro, it was like perfectly stated what you said. You know, I struggle to subscribe to myself, you know what I'm saying? But I do it just to see what I'ma say. Like, I go and listen to it afterwards, like, yo, this dude is tripping. Yo, Tijuana Wise said, I believe she's talking about Dre, they was married for like 20 years. What part of two becomes one do people not understand? Half is hers, period. I think the part folks don't understand is the half is hers part. You see what I'm saying? Grand Highsmith came through and said, yo, this dude is crazy, unless I'm just high. My question is, how high did you get? Now, first on the chopping block is Dre's marriage. I hate to say it like that. You know what I'm saying? Marriage is a beautiful thing, if you know how to take an L, that is. Now, we all know that Dr. Dre's estranged wife, Nicole Young, has been asking for approximately $2 million a month in spousal support. Well, it's really 1.9 and change, but we might as well say $2 million, and that is apart from the $5 million in lawyer's fees. Now, there's a difference, right, between this spousal support situation and future's baby mother child support situation. Remember, she demanded $53,000 a month. First off, Dre was married 25 years. Future situation was like a girlfriend or maybe a hot night. I don't know what it was. A baby was a result. That's what I know, right? Now, I'm not saying it was a one-night stand. The other key difference is this. Eliza Rain Seraphine, Future's piece, expressed that her aim wasn't quite $53,000 a month, but the team that she was working with came up with that number, and she rode with it, among other things. If I understand the situation correctly, you know what I'm saying, comprehension skills could be a bit questionable at times, but Eliza's aim wasn't $53,000 a month. But Nicole Young, on the other hand, definitely wants that 1.9 mil a month because greed. And of course, expenses. Hey yo, here's the breakdown according to TMZ, because I know you was like, what somebody need $2 million a month for? Well, let me tell you. Laundry and cleaning, $10,000 per month. It's a big house, what do you want? Clothes, $135,000 per month. The rest of the clothes is in the laundry, bro. Come on. Education, that is tuition and living expenses, $60,000 per month. High education, man. I mean, it's funny how the clothes is more expensive than the education, but whatever. Entertainment, $900,000 a month. The most expensive thing on this list, might I add. Charitable contributions, $125,000 per month. Yo, we need details on that, lady. Which charities exactly? Mortgage, $100,000 per month, which I would have thought would have been the most expensive thing on a list. And telephones, cell phone, and email, $20,000 per month. She must have like 20 Note Ultras and the email, she must have some kind of insane fiber optic unlimited data. That's crazy, $20,000 a month? Come on, the numbers are crazy. Now, I'm sure she's trying to lowball them so they can meet somewhere in the middle reasonably. But, I mean, they should make it, right? Like, if you aim too high at things like this, you lose everything. You see what I'm saying? Like, the price is right. There should be a penalty for greed. That's all I'm saying. Oh, that's right. There is a penalty. It's called Judgment Day. 10th commandment, y'all. And speaking of commandments, is there one that says, thou shalt not keep the imprisoned away from the opportunity to practice their beliefs? I mean, surely it's in there. If it is, then the correctional facility in Kentucky that is holding Kodak Black will be answering for their sins. It's Sunday, y'all. You ain't been to church. Although Kodak is not Jewish, he has not been able to access a representative from the Jewish faith. Let me correct that. He has been denied access to a rep from the Jewish faith, Kodak's lawyer Bradford Cohen stated that the detention center's chaplain has told him all face-to-face meetings with chaplains and the like have been postponed and suspended due to COVID. Okay, we get it. But they're not even allowing Kodak to call or Zoom his rabbi. They won't even have a Zoom meeting. I guess dude is like, yo, I ain't trying to work, period. You see what I'm saying? So, as you could have guessed, Kodak's lawyer, Cohen, is suing on First Amendment grounds, stating they will not allow him to access his religion. Now, the Bureau of Prisons won't speak on Kodak's complaint, but they stated that they go to great lengths to accommodate inmates' religious and spiritual needs. Do y'all? Something tells me I doubt it. Talk about making lemonade out of lemons. 6ix9ine released an album called Tattletales. It's like he molded an intricate castle out of poop. It's projected to open with a 100K week, which will end Taylor Swift's 6-week run at the top of the charts. Imagine Taylor Swift toppled by 6ix9ine. It's like he pulled a Kanye and ran up on stage and was like, I'm sorry, Taylor, but Tattletales is the greatest album of all time. And then shrugs and walks off. Now, I know you're dying to know whether 6ix9ine's Tattletales is hot or hitting or whatever, which you can easily look up yourself. Well, Lil Durk has given us his thoughts on 6ix9ine's album. It makes me wonder if he listened to it. He stated, one song, he's referring to his song, is better than a whole album. I'm really Chicago's Jay-Z, The Voice. Close quote. Essentially saying that his one song trumps the whole album, Tattletales. I think it would have been better if he asked us which is better. You follow me? I mean, let the people decide. Now, once again, 6ix9ine is accusing the industry of throttling his success. He posted images on the gram of streaming services pushing Big Sean's album and SZA's album, but ignoring his Tattletale drop, maybe because he's unaware of the fact that all of society is against the concept of tattletaling in general. When you build your brand off the concept of tattletaling, you should know it ain't gonna get no love. You follow what I'm saying? I mean, I guess I can't say that because he knocked off Taylor Swift. So maybe there are mad people that are following him. Now, remember though, months ago, he did say he was going to use credit cards to purchase stream counts. Now, 6ix9ine stated, quote, when the industry knows that you are a monster and you can't be stopped, they make sure they do everything in their power to make you lose. These award shows, these top charters are there because they want them to be, and they'll beat them in your face till you think you like them. Actually, I think I agree with him on that. I really honestly do. I dropped the album today, and they have completely blacklisted it so no one can see it at, you know, some heads in Apple and whatnot. The industry is rigged. Close quote. It's like if Trump was gonna drop an album and he starts spitting that whole, yo, the whole thing is rigged nonsense, like he's preparing for it to bomb. Remember election night when the dude won and he was completely shocked? He was like, I can't believe these folks fell for it. I almost called him something else. And finally, what do the streets have to say about all this? Well, the streets are absolutely livid. The idea that this album has released has made some folks take time out of their busy schedules to express their feelings for the Tattletale. Tattler, whatever the word is. Take a look. Has us wondering, why is that guy not at work? Who's his employer? In fact, don't post who his employer is. I don't want the man to lose his gig because someone decided to rat on him. You see what I'm saying? You'll let us know what you think. What kind of entertainment costs $900,000? And you think the rabbi don't want to see Kodak because they think he's trolling them? And honestly, what would you do if you saw 6ix9ine? None of this legendary stuff neither. You see what I'm saying? Like, give us your real human behavior. Like, based on what your past behavior is like, what might you honestly think that you would do or say if you bumped into the artist? Yo, post it down in the comments below. Be sure to like. Man, show us a little bit of love. Show us a little bit of support if we keep you entertained for 10 minutes. You follow what I'm saying? Or 5, whatever, I don't care. You know what I mean? Yo, thanks for tuning in. Be sure to like, be sure to subscribe. Thanks for tuning in to Celeb Source, your source for celeb news.